back to my channel. So for today's video, we have a full face of Wet n Wild makeup. Again, disclaimer, I didn't buy all of this at one shot. I've been buying them over a period of time. Some of the products I bought from Nykaa and some of them I bought from hokbeauty.com. To be very honest, you find a lot more products of Makeup Revolution and Wet n Wild and a lot of other brands on hokbeauty.com, and they always have some or the other offer going on. So I would highly recommend you guys check out hokbeauty.com. This is not a sponsored video. HOK probably doesn't even know I exist, but I really found that website super helpful when it comes to saving a lot of money, because they always have offers. I don't know how that works. So without any further ado, let's get into this video. So I don't really have any eyebrow product, but I have the Ultimate Brow Highlighter from Wet n Wild. So what this basically does is, do you guys remember how we used to use concealer to carve out or shape out our eyebrows? This is just an easier way of doing that. I really like this product because it blends into the skin very well, even though it's really light. I'm also going to use the concealer, which is the Photo Focus Concealer from Wet n Wild in the shade Medium Deep Tan. And I'm going to apply that all over my eyelids for it to act as a base, as a primer. Okay, so for eyeshadows, I have one eyeshadow palette. Of course, I know you guys love the drugstore versus high-end video, and you may have purchased this after that video. So I want to create more looks using this palette so you can get the best of this palette. So I'm going to be using all of the shades that I did not use in my last video. Also bought a couple of single eyeshadows. I'm quickly going to swatch them and show them to you guys. Some of them are really glittery, like chunky glittery. Some of them have a nice sheen, and the others are just matte eyeshadows. They're really nice. They're only 99 bucks on the hokbeauty.com. Otherwise, their MRP is 135 bucks. There's hair in my mouth. Let's ignore that. Brulee on my eyes. They have a lot of kickback, but also a good pigment. So not going to complain for 99 bucks. Let me pick up this shade right here and apply that as a transition. I really like how pigmented these eyeshadows are. I mean, I feel like I'll just keep saying that forever about Wet n Wild, because I love that a brand is able to produce good quality product and also cruelty-free products at this price. A smaller blending brush and pick up this shade because we want some warmth in the eye. And the eyeshadows blend so well. That's another thing that I love, is how they blend so well, so beautifully. Grab this brown right here and deepen the crease. I'm quickly going to use a little bit of makeup remover and erase the excess. I'm also going to quickly grab this shade and highlight my eyebrow bone. It's nutty, and I'm going to grab that and apply that all over my eyelids. It's just going to act like a base for the eyeshadows that we're going to be putting on. So I'm quickly just going to use a setting spray from Wet n Wild. This is the matte finish setting spray. I love it. I also love how it smells. Yeah, so these eyeshadows look way better when wet. So the eyeshadow we're going to be trying is this one called Nudecomer. What? This chunky, glittery eyeshadow, and I'm just going to pick that and put that on the center of my eyelid. It's so pretty. I love this eyeshadow. Wet n Wild Liquid Catsuit Eyeshadows. These are the liquid eyeshadows from their range. The only difference between shells and whistles and the other two eyeshadows are that the other two are pretty glittery, and this one has just got a nice sheen to it. It actually is a good base for putting the eyeshadow on top of it. So maybe today I'm going to be using the Cashmere Love. Like that. That's pretty. Here's a funny fact about me. I do not like liner on my face at all, but I still wanted to try the Wet n Wild Pro Line Felt Tip Liner in dark brown. So sometimes I feel like black looks too dark for my skin tone and I don't really like how it looks. But I really, really enjoyed using this product. It's really pigmented, very easy to apply. It's got a very thin tip, so it makes it easier for the wing. But I genuinely like how this looks on my skin tone. In the sense, it's not too dark, but at the same time, it does give you a liner effect. So if you are somebody like me, you will really enjoy this product. I'm going to quickly curl my lashes and used the Wet n Wild Mega Length Mascara. This is a waterproof mascara. And this one really lengthens your lashes, but doesn't really add volume to it. So ideally, it would be perfect for your lower lash line, but this is what I have. So I'm going to use it for my upper lash line as well. Two foundations because I was confused with my color, so I bought one which is mocha, which is way too dark for me. The one is toffee. I'm guessing if I mix them both, I'd get like a good shade, even though I feel like toffee is a good shade for my skin tone. Comes with a spatula, so you basically just have to do that. How cool is that? I'm going to quickly blend this all together. Actually, you know what? I feel like I need to use a brush with this foundation because the beauty blender seems to be drinking all of the foundation. Yes, way better. So this foundation performs better on a brush. Just going to use a little bit of this. I think the shade toffee was actually a good match to my skin, but I was greedy and I mixed the other shade. Make sure everything is blended and the excess product comes off in this. I really don't like the way it smells. It smells like those thick oils. I think this foundation is really nice in the sense it gives you a very natural finish. There's a little bit of glow, but also doesn't feel too sticky. So that's a yay. I'm gonna be using the shade Medium Deep Tan on my under eye as a concealer. This concealer is not too thick from what I have used in the past. That's why I'm even putting so much, because otherwise I wouldn't have. You know me guys. Right off the bat, I really like this concealer. I mean, I like this particular shade on my skin tone. I think it just gives me the right amount of coverage and highlight that my skin needs. So, what do you guys think? Okay, we're quickly gonna go ahead and powder our face, for which I'm gonna be using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Press Powder. I'm gonna be using the Wet n Wild Contouring Palette. It's actually not a contour. I feel like it's more like a bronzer. It kind of gives you that bronzed effect rather than that stark contour. I don't know if you guys understand what I mean. So I'm going to be picking up this shade called Pearlescent Pink from the Wet n Wild Color Icon Blush. We're anyway not going to use that brush ever. It's a nice corally blush that shows up on brown skin but also has a little bit of a sheen, if you can tell. So it adds a little bit of glow to the face. I'm just gonna quickly spritz this before I move on with the highlighter. Just going to quickly tap on it. Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder in Crown of My Canopy. Do a quick swatch. That's what it looks like. I think it looks pretty fine. Lot of fallout. Highlight. Oh yes, that's what I'm talking about for an everyday glow.
Bubble my way. I love it.
Okay, so for lips, I have a couple of products. In the sense, I have a lot of products. So I'm going to show you all of them so you can decide which ones you want to purchase. I'm just going to make your life easy. You're welcome. Of Wet n Wild lip liners. I have four of them. The shade Chestnut. Second one is the shade Willow and Fab Fuchsia, which is like this really nice pink. And then Brandy Wine, that's a really nice brown that looks like that. So maybe Wet n Wild Velvet Matte Lip Color Toffee Frappe, which is a really nice pinky nude that looks like that. Charred Cherry, which looks like that. Glosses, this is in the shade Sweet Gaze. I feel like this is one of the best lip gloss formulas that I have ever tried. It's basically a clear lip gloss with a little bit of a pink in it, but it's not sticky. It's really liquidy, but also gives you the correct glossy effect. A raspberry voice. I definitely don't have a raspberry voice. It's got a nice sheen to it. It's a very nice pinky, corally lip gloss. Cherish. It's like a champagne-y, pinky, cool toned lip gloss. Catsuit Matte Lipstick in the shade Flame of the Game. This really nice orange liquid lipstick. Generally, I don't buy orange lipsticks or liquid lipsticks at all because they never show up on my skin. Unlike this one, this actually shows up on my skin. But my most favorite one are these two, which is number one, Gimme Mocha. This is a really, really nice shade. It's so nice for our brown girls. So I actually bought two of these. I really love this shade. This is the Gimme Mocha. And there's another one, which is the Rebel Rose, which is also really, really nice for brown girls. So the Gimme Mocha is a little bit of a brown nude. And of course, the Rebel Rose is a little bit of a pinky nude. Wet n Wild Lipsticks in the Flesh, which is a really nice pinky nude. Bare It All, which is a really nice brownie pinky nude. It's got a mix of both brown and pink. Cherry Picking, which is a really nice fuchsia pink, which would really go very well with the pink fuchsia lip pencil. Raven Raisin, which is a really nice purple, but not really purple. It's really nice mauve. So the Brandy Wine to lip line. Oh wow, these are not as soft as the lip liner should be, but I still won't complain. Now you know why I love this shade, right? Everyday, if not very simple makeup look. If you minus the glitter, you can actually wear it every day, even to office. It's not too shabam on the face. So I think it's really nice. Okay, let me explain. So Krishna kept barking, so I took a take care of him and I completely forgot to press the record button. But what I did was I used the same eyebrow highlighter on my waterline as the kajal. And I also added the Emerald Gaze Catsuit liquid eyeshadow on my inner corner, towards my inner corner on my lower lash line. And on the outer side, I blended it with the dark brown eyeshadow from the Rose in the Air palette. That's all I did, guys, and added mascara, of course, to my waterline. I'm so sorry. And I also added the Shells and Whistles on my inner corner as an inner corner highlight. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I really like this look. You can stop at any point. I feel like I also should have stopped without adding the green, but I just wanted to try all the products and show you guys what it looks like so you can make a decision when you're deciding to buy it. If you guys did like this video, then please leave a thumbs up. If you want me to do any other videos, then please leave that as a comment down below. And a few words about the Wet n Wild brand. I feel like they're affordable, cruelty-free, and also great quality for the money that you're paying. I really like most of their products. There are just a few misses here and there, but most of them are a hit. I will always support them, even though they don't even know I exist. I really like how this turned out. I love their liquid lipsticks. So if you are a fan of liquid lipsticks, but you want them to be a little affordable, you should totally go for the Wet n Wild one because they're amazing. Also, the blush showed up on my skin pretty well. Love it. I love their eyeshadows. They're really pigmented and of great quality, if you can actually see and tell. I really like the brown liner also. It's not as dark as a black liner would be, but at the same time did what a liner should be doing. Foundation, it sat on my skin so well. I don't even feel like I'm wearing foundation. This is so nice for an everyday use. You can either use very little of this to get minimum coverage and also keep building to get maximum coverage. So I really like this foundation, and also let's appreciate their inclusivity towards brown girls. I love that they have so many shades available, and I also love their concealer a lot. They have no flashback. I did try it, there's no flashback. And the concealers blend in pretty well, and they don't really sit on the skin like a few concealers do. So I really like this brand a lot, and I feel like they have to release more products and I have to buy more products. Obviously, video comes to an end. Until I see you guys in my next video, this is me saying bye to you guys and bye.